Welcome to a lesson on the loan formula. This lesson is about conventional loans, also called amortized loans or installment loans. Examples include auto loans and home mortgages. The techniques in this lesson do not apply to payday loans, add-on loans, or other loan types where the interest is calculated up front, though I do have lessons on these topics. One great thing about loans is that we can use the same formula as a payout annuity. To see why, imagine that you had $10,000 invested at a bank. You start taking out withdrawals while earning interest on the remaining balance as part of a payout annuity. After 5 years, your balance is zero. Flip that around and imagine that you borrow $10,000 from a bank. You make payments back to the bank with interest for the money you borrow. After 5 years, the loan is paid off. The roles are reversed here, but the formula to describe the situation is the same. So here is the loan formula, which again is the same as the payout annuity formula, where P sub 0 is the loan amount or beginning balance or principal, D is the loan payment or the payment per unit of time, R is the annual interest rate expressed as a decimal, K is the number of compounding periods in 1 year. Notice K appears 3 times in the formula. And N is the length of the loan in years. Now the compounding frequency is not always explicitly given, but can be determined by how often payments are made. Before we take a look at two examples though, it is important to be very careful about rounding when calculations involve exponents. In general, keep as many decimals during calculations as you can. Be sure to keep at least 3 significant digits, meaning 3 numbers after any leading zeros. For example, to round this decimal using 3 significant digits, we would have 0.000123. Using 3 significant digits will usually give you a close enough answer, but keeping more digits is always better. Let's take a look at our first example. If you can afford a $150 per month car payment for 5 years, what car price should you shop for? The loan interest is 6%. Let's start by finding all the given information. If the monthly payment is $150, then we know that D equals 150. And because the payments are monthly, we can assume the number of compounds would be 12 per year or monthly, and therefore K equals 12. The loan is for 5 years, so N is 5. And finally, the interest rate is 6%, so R equals 6%, but this must be expressed as a decimal, which should be 0.06. And our goal here is to find the loan amount, or the principal, which would be P sub 0. So now we'll sub these values into our formula and find P sub 0. So D equals 150, which is here. K equals 12, which is here, here, and here. N equals 5, which is here. And finally, R is equal to 0.06, which is here and here. And since we're solving for P sub 0, we need to evaluate the right side here. We'll begin by simplifying inside the parentheses in the numerator and then the denominator. So looking at the numerator in parentheses, we'd have 1 minus the quantity 1 plus 0.06 divided by 12. We want to raise this to the power of, this would be negative 60. We can hit the exponent key or the caret here. Then in parentheses, we can just type in negative 5 times 12. Close parenthesis and enter. Notice how I decided to use all the decimal places here. Now the denominator is going to be 0.06 divided by 12. Which is 0.005. So now we'll find the product in the numerator and divide by the denominator to determine what the loan amount would be. So we'll put the numerator in parentheses. So we'll have 150 times this decimal here, 0.258, 627-8038. And then we'll divide this by 0.005. Run to the nearest cent, we have $7,758.83. So this tells us that under these conditions, if you can afford a $150 payment per month, you should shop for a car around this price. But it's important to not forget about insurance for the car as well, which would be an extra cost. Now let's take a look at a second example. In this example, you want to purchase a car for $15,000 and you have been approved for a loan at 4% interest for 5 years. What will the monthly payment be? Again, let's start by determining the given information. The loan amount would be $15,000, and therefore P sub 0 equals 15,000. The loan is at 4%, so R would be 4% expressed as a decimal. That would be 0.04. The loan is for 5 years, so N is equal to 5. And the payments are going to be monthly, so K would be 12. So our goal here is to find the monthly payment amount, which would be D. So now we'll substitute these values into our formula, and this time we'll be solving for D. So P sub 0 equals 15,000. R equals 0.04. N equals 5. K equals 12. K is here, here, and here. And now we want to solve for D. So we'll begin by simplifying inside the parentheses in the numerator and then in the denominator. Looking at the numerator inside the parentheses, we'd have 1 minus the quantity 1 plus 0.04 divided by 12. Close parenthesis. We're going to raise this to the power of negative 60, or raise it to the power of negative 5 times 12, which gives us this decimal here. Notice how this is still multiplied by D, though. In our denominator, we have 0.04 divided by 12, which gives us this decimal here. Now for the next step, we'll find this quotient here and then multiply by D. So we'd have 0.180996-8963 divided by 0.00 followed by 8 threes. So notice how this would be the coefficient of D, meaning we'd now multiply this by D, giving us this term here. Now notice in this case, to solve for D, we have to divide both sides by the coefficient. So we have just D on the right side, and now we'll find this quotient to find the monthly payment. So we'd have 15,000 divided by 54.299-07433. Running to the nearest cent, this gives us the monthly payment would be $276.25. I hope you found this lesson helpful.